Hello everyone and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I'm Exorph and we are still here in the dungeons of Irithyll. We really need to find a way to get back to where we were quickly. I'm a bit worried about how likely that is to happen. We should at least give it a go, shouldn't we? Oh god damn, you lose health so quickly. And I am in a horrible spot now, I think. This is probably not the best thing that could happen. Let's try to sneak out of here. As well as we can. But that could have gone better, for sure. I'm wondering if we can like run up here. Without bothering the other enemy too much. I don't think we have anything for that door yet. But yeah, I'm a bit worried about that enemy up there. And just the idea of running right up the stairs seems like a good thing. If we can, that might be the best way of actually avoiding getting too hurt. So might want to just heal up a little bit. I don't know if I actually lost any health there. I'm kind of assuming that I did. Okay. So, can we tell when the other enemy is actually heading away from us? Because I don't want to have to deal with two of those at the same time. We're going to have to do that a bit later. But for now, it would be nice to just have the one. Okay, so there that one comes. Hopefully it's going to turn away. Anytime now. And that's probably going to lead to a bunch of other enemies attacking us at the same time. But we should be good. I would hope. I wonder if there's a way to avoid that happening. Or if that will actually always happen. Oh, goddammit. So let's try to sneak up on that to avoid it to as high a degree as we actually can, at least. But then I believe we need to find the entrance to the elevator, which is downstairs somewhere. But I'm not, like, completely certain of where, which is a problem. Is it actually going to come in all the way, or is it going to turn away here? Hey, we didn't lose any health. Huh. I really don't like that attack those enemies have. It's really fucking annoying. Am I just gonna get attacked by another one of those enemies when I come down here? Was there another one of the wardens or whatever in here? No, alright. Yeah, I'll take that hit. I think that's fine. So, alright. We're kind of back to everywhere at least. There's a lot of enemies that we need to, like, take out as we are in order to get back right where we were. So I guess this is like a dragon guy then. Guess this is the body I'm getting if I use the dragon torso item. Oh, what are you looking at, though? Like, what is that place? I never even noticed that. Because that, like, feels at least like it's far away from everything else. Yeah, I don't recognize that, right? At least I don't think so, but I'm guessing we'll have to go there at some point. Alright, that's interesting. Alright, one thing that I didn't do when we picked it up was to check the lore on the Great Miracle. Great Heal Miracle, rather. Which we probably should. Guessing I won't be using this for a while, at least. Yeah, faith 14, and we need 25, so yeah, that's not gonna happen. Glorious miracle used by high-ranking clerics. Restores a large amount of HP for herself and those in the vicinity. Only a select few have learned to recite this epic tale in its entirety, but those who do are amply rewarded. So, guessing then that those slime blobby guys that I picked this up from are high-ranking clerics. So, how to deal with this shit. Now we need to handle this one more time. I'm not looking forward to it. Like I said, it feels like it might be possible to do this like a stealth segment. But I'm not sure. There's so many of them. It's like insane how many there are. I mean, we had a fair bit of luck taking care of them in there, but I don't want to run in there because I think there are a bunch of enemies in there that I would prefer to not have to deal with. But yeah, it looked like they're like walking around in two groups, so you can probably like sneak around them if you really want to. But it doesn't seem like it notices you that easily either. Which might mean that we are indeed supposed to handle it like a stealth bit. Oh, Jesus, what is going on in there? There's some crazy bugs happening right now. I wonder if actually running up to it would trigger all of the other ones. Because that one is fairly isolated from all the rest. After all. So maybe we're safe. Oh, we are totally not safe. I need to get out of here. I wonder what even triggers that that health loss. So I'm not losing. Oh, now I'm losing. Shit. But at least they try to follow you. That's nice, but Jesus, I don't. I would really like to know exactly what triggers this, because it's quite a huge chunk of health that they do that they take from you every single time. And you know, really, though, I'm not sure that the mana or whatever Estus is actually helping us here, because it might be better to just have two or three more. Is it two? Oh, it's three. Oh no, it's just two. I haven't used one yet. Two or three more normal Estus flasks. Okay, but we're gonna try to do this at least. Because they do seem like they want to actually come to us once they actually do spot you. But yeah, that totally is coming my way now. And I don't even have to attack it, you know? That's good. If we can make that happen with everyone, then we're probably fine. Okay, anyone left? We know that there's one in there, and I don't know if we fully explored that place, honestly. We did fully explore this room in here. Right. Is this the same room? That is the mimic that we didn't actually kill. But it shouldn't contain any item now, since we used the Lloyd's talisman on it. The heal aid really isn't like doing anything at this point. Oh, did you notice me now? For some reason? Can get you to blow the candle out? I really wish I was clear on exactly what caused that stuff. Princess head. It is locked. There's a lot of locked stuff here. I want the key to open all of this. I really, really do. But I have no idea where to get it. Don't you dare. Alright. No secret head. Pointless head. Everyone is saying it's pointless. Do we check where this actually leads first? See if there would happen to be like a bonfire or something ahead here. I'm just a bit worried about leaving a door like that. Even if it might mean my doom to go in there. Oh, so this is the Profaned Capital? Is it? We got a key telling us that, or implying that this would be the Profaned Capital, but it feels very odd that it is. I don't know exactly where we came out to see this the first time around. I don't know where I am, geography-wise. But, alright, I think we are actually going to head in there to the pointless room and kill that pointless enemy. Because, why not? Why not? Whoa, I did not expect you to be able to go through that. Whoa, and I thought I was going to get out of there. Whoa, and you have so many attacks! Ah. Yes, thank you. Was it pointless? It's probably pointless, isn't it? It is totally pointless. Anything? Anything at all? Yeah. I mean, I don't know what I expected. I guess I expected it to be pointless, just like I said. But we should probably still applaud all of these messages. So yeah, okay, kind of want to go back to the other weapon though, the twin blades. They, I don't know if they're better, but I don't know. It's, we have played a lot with that other sword for so long that it feels like we should be playing around with other stuff for a bit. Dum-dum-dum. Now where is this taking us? I was kind of hoping for a bonfire. I mean, I didn't dare to go all the way... all the way out there last time because I had, like, no health whatsoever and such. But, yeah, it's still, we're still fairly far away from a bonfire. But of course, we found a shortcut, so chances are there isn't a bonfire anywhere close. Can we see one or something from here? Doesn't look like it. It's mostly that I don't want to have to go through that room again, since it's a bit of a crazy long room. So yeah, this is the Profaned Capital, I guess. That is interesting. And that is scary. Is that? Huh. What is that? It's reminding me of something. Ugh. And I can't... I mean, I think it probably just reminding me of the gargoyle. If it keeps on doing this, then we're probably good. But it doesn't. What are you doing? Please do more stabbing. I like the stabs. Do not like these attacks. I can't tell what the hell you're doing right now. Can I want to go in front of you since that was the easiest attack to avoid? This is a bit weird. Or unusual, at least. But it's not not too bad. Like, we can fairly easily guard through all of this. I just need to be a bit more aggressive, because I'm not really attacking when I should. Like that. I think you're dead now. Awesome! Thank you for that. That was cool. Like, a nice way of getting introduced to this place. I hope I don't have to kill it again, though. I'd really like to not have to do that. Looks like there might be a bonfire over there. But I might be wrong, too. It's a bit unclear, honestly. And looks like this is just going to send me down. Yeah, there is a bonfire there. But I do not know how to actually get to it. It might be that we can't get to it, which is a shame. Can we tell? Yeah, there is a ladder there, so we can get to the ladder without having to do something horrible down here. Then we're probably fine. Okay, I think we're good. Finally. I don't know if we have enough souls that we need to head back to the Firelink Shrine just yet, but it's, guess it's worth, like, just heading back there and checking in on everything, seeing if anything has changed from us getting here. Stretched out. And under the bullshit. And I believe we got some other stuff as well. Didn't we get, perhaps we didn't get any other things that we need to leave with people. Oh well, we're gonna head back to burn some shards at least. This is an interesting place. We might actually want to just head back to Irithyll as well, since we kind of started out going that way, and it feels weird to just head in a completely different direction. That's something to consider. But first, let's head back to the Firelink Shrine. So first, let's burn the Undead Bone Shards. We didn't have two of those, did we? No. Okay. I think I want to build the dexterity a bit. We haven't, I would prefer to have it, like, at least at 25. Have it be one of my most one of my highest stats. So let's go with this. And we're gonna have a quick run around this place just to let's just check if there's anything new, because we haven't done a full exploration of this place in a while. So I kind of want to do that. We should probably reinforce this in case we need to go back and use this more. Alright, we have so many of these large titanite shards at this point, so that seems like it would be a fine thing to do. Oh, it's at the same level as our twin blades. And we are going to go with 12 Estus Flask uses instead of having a bunch of... having too much FP. I guess we'll can probably live with having no way of regaining FP, since the only thing we're using the FP for is to heal ourselves. Which I've never really considered how silly that is of me. We haven't found many of these scrolls, like, at all. Which is kind of weird. I don't mean found a couple ones at start, but then nothing. Oh! We got the seed of a giant tree. Do not know if they do the same thing in this game as in Dark Souls 2, where they, I think they just make enemies attack invaders as well. Enemies react to invaders. The giant trees were also known as watcher trees, and their seeds unmasks invaders. When used effectively, these seeds will help counter dark spirits. Okay, I was kind of expecting something more from that, honestly. But I guess that's fine. Oh, we're back here, but I kind of hoped something cool would be here who ran all the way back here, but I guess not the case. And I don't know why I really thought that was would be. It is interesting though with this guy that this is the only... It's obviously that this guy is special in some way. And he does look like a knight from Dark Souls 1. And we haven't seen any other knight like that, so... Feels like... That's intentional. Which I don't know why it wouldn't be. Alright, we are back here in in Irithyll. Because I think this is probably where we want to keep on going. Then we can take care of the Profaned Capital later on. So, we're gonna head right to the shortcut. Hopefully that's not going to attract too many enemies. Only you can just sort of run through this place. Seems like it. That's nice. And of course we want to send this elevator back up. Now we need to figure out how to handle these guys from this angle. Which is a bit different from before. Almost wondering if we don't want to just sort of go up here immediately, where we can be protected against the magic and such. I don't know if anyone else is actually going to come for me here, but it doesn't look like it. Seems like he's the only guy. Oh! Please die. I wonder what's up with that dog. Or I guess all of the dogs are like... has that frozen effect when they are in their idle state. Alright, so a lot of these messages seem to suggest I should go this way first. And so I will. I don't know how much it actually helps. Certainly does take a fair chunk of, from my health, but yeah. I've noticed all of these patterns. I talked about these in like a very early episode. And tried to get a good angle on one of them. Yeah, there, probably. I feel like they're pretty much all over this place. And I've thought maybe it had to do with the Cathedral of Blue and such, but I'm kind of starting to doubt myself. It might just be a pattern they use in certain types of areas that doesn't actually mean anything. Oh shit, what did I pick up there? I am not sure I actually registered that. So I'm guessing we'll, like, get into this place from behind the enemies now. Yeah, looks like it. I guess these guys would be, like, up here and shooting stuff at us and being generally annoying. And we would probably come in down there. Yeah, that seems likely. What about you? Are you actually doing something? I mean, we can't talk to you, so we gotta assume that you're an enemy. And you were. So I guess we could go down there and fight all these enemies, or we could head straight up here. Which is probably progression, but we are going to take care of these guys, if we can. I wonder if this essentially means that we can backstab, like, all of them. Maybe not all of them, but a lot of them. I don't mind. I like backstabbing. I like it quite a lot. Oh, that was close. Yeah, it's no fun when they're actually invisible. It's one thing when they have that, that fairly obvious smoke effect coming off their heads, even as they're invisible, but as soon as they're, like, genuinely impossible to see, they get a bit more annoying. blue bug pellets, nothing I plan on using anytime soon. Okay, we are making progress here. Anything obvious that we can see up there so that we're not running straight into danger? Is this actually going to take us up top, where we could drop down on the items in the cathedral-like area down there? That would be nice. I've sort of been wondering where... how to actually get to those. Oh, you have a different item, weapon entirely. And I cannot backstab you here. That's just not going to happen. Okay, that was really bad. And you are causing bleeding on me, which is not nice at all. Can you please stop that? Like, right now? Maybe you should actually head in here. Try to get around you. I do not like that combo. But they do have a tendency to attack a lot of time. Like, way too much in a row, these guys. Ah, that was probably not good. Especially not with this guy actually, like, causing... Whoa. I do wonder if there's a way to stagger you, though. Okay, cool. I'm always taking way too long to fight these enemies. It's like, they're fairly easy once you start attacking them. I'm just waiting for an opening until I die a lot of the time, which is just very stupid of me. Very, very stupid. So was there another guy? I did feel like I heard activities from someone else up here as well. Okay, is that a boss? It sure feels like it would be. And yeah, we could drop down there to get an item, which we probably want to do before we try to take on the boss. And probably, yeah, we probably won't actually go into the boss room this episode, honestly. That seems somewhat unlikely. Like a lot of you want to. Okay, we got another one of those annoying ones. Want to actually head closer to me? I don't really like the idea of running towards that guy. And they're coming back. I thought they would, like, just head out, not come running, not come back, are we? Wanna do the magic attack? Because I want to backstab you. Not that way. There we go. Whoa! I do not know why I did the backflip attack there. I did not do a combo attack, like, at all. I'm 99% sure of that. Visions of Youth? Is that a more clear... I think we haven't seen so much detail in these cleric or whatever statues before. I don't think so, at least. Any secrets around there? It feels like a big, empty area, which is a bit weird. With, like, a very ugly view as well. I guess that's kind of cool. We have the everything sort of disappearing into the mist or the clouds. Yeah. The sort of architecture over there feels very on Orlando. It wouldn't surprise me if we had even more Anorlana connections going forward. So I think we should be able to open up a secret door here. And I was right. So let's do that before we actually... Oh. Before we do anything else. Then we have another shortcut to get back here really quickly. Like, surprisingly quickly even. We should be able to, like, just run straight into the boss room fairly easily. And when we actually need to get back there. Assuming, of course, that I do have to get back there, which seems very likely. This is a very imposing boss door. What's there a statue on the other side as well? Oh, okay, it's just the same one. I do want to jump down there when the other enemies are actually looking away, preferably. Ring of the Sun's Firstborn. Actually, let's just, for the sake of it, sake of safety, use a Homeward Bone to get back to the last bonfire rest of that. So we don't have to head through a bunch of fire witches and such. That's a very convenient little shortcut there. Let's check the ring. Ring of the Sun's Firstborn, who inherited the light of Gwyn, the First Lord, greatly boosts miracles. The Sun's Firstborn was once a god of war, until it was stripped of its stature as punishment for his foolishness. No wonder his very name was slipped from the annals of history. So yeah, that's the same as in Dark Souls 1. Did we actually hear anything about... The Firstborn inheriting the light of Gwyn, though? Is that something that happened afterwards? I don't know. But we are going to fight a boss, I guess, in the next episode. So until then, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time on Dark Souls 3. Bye-bye.